Tonight, we'd like to discuss about two issues. This is a politician who to the NRM is one of the radical in the opposition. He's the opposition chief whip, member of parliament representing the people of Chiramu municipality, and also the spokesperson of the main forum for democratic change, political party, the Honorable Ibrahim Ssemujju. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. And
you seem to be enemies with the President Museveni. What did he do to you?
We are not.
Therefore, even by the virtue of the number of years he's been in power, it means that all the problems that Uganda face today, Mr. Museveni is singularly accountable as a leader. So I don't have any problem, but I keep pointing out the mistakes he has made. And to error is it's human.
Can't you have dialogue with President Museveni on issues you disagree on?
I don't have a personal problem, Museveni. I have a problem with methods of work. And I have said this country runs the trouble of replacing Museveni with Museveni. Because many people look at the personalities. It's the same problem you have seen with the police. Now Kaihura has gone, people are clapping because Ochora has come. But the environment under which Kaihura was serving, that environment remains.
Honorable, if opportunity comes, can you ever work under President Museveni's government?
I like institutions. So if we set up institutions of serving the country and we agree that Mr. Museveni will be a transitional leader for 1 year or 2 years, why not? I can serve under him and then we give him a package and retire him peacefully and then we set a new foundation for this country.
Yeah, many in the NRM call you specifically and some of your colleagues in the FDC as radicals, and you don't know anything good about the NRM. Is this true?
When we are recording Capital Gang at State House in Teve, we were asked to make our final remarks. And the final remarks, I asked Mr. Museveni if he really appreciates the meaning of the word nepotism. And I asked him, do you feel comfortable chairing a cabinet when your wife is a minister? Are you in a position to supervise your wife or to chair the high command and your son is a member? Frank Atumwebaze grabbed the microphone from me. Frank Atumwebaze. Until Mr. Museveni told him, because Museveni, with all his weaknesses, is more tolerant than many people who serve under him. He was the one telling Frank, just leave him. But to ask those questions, Frank Atumwebaze felt offended. So many NRM people who call us radicals, they are actually the ones who are radicals.
You say that in the NRM, they take Museveni as the alpha and the omega, but you also have a one Chiza Besigye in the FDC.
I have worked with Besigye. He's a very fantastic human being. But because of the contribution he has made, there are people who think now he has earned the right not to be criticized. And I told them, I am not part of that. In the last election, I said, so I even wrote it, that even Besigye is not beyond criticism. While he's leading us to struggle for our freedom, but even when he gets into power. People who think that you cannot criticize Dr. Besigye, just imagine when he gets into power. And for me, I am never part. I don't pretend.
Honorable Ssemujju, you supported General Mugisha Muntu against the current party president, Engineer Amuri Atoboi. And now Muntu is having consultations all over the country, which to Engineer Amriat is not good for the future of the party. Do you agree with him?
I was the chairman of his campaign. I am not part of his consultation. I remain loyal to the FDC and I'll serve the FDC because FDC is not like NRM, which is like a military. This is not owned by anyone. We all have made a contribution to making FDC.
How can the two irreconcilable approaches, defiance and then organization in the FDC, can be accommodated?
I said and I told our colleagues who are running the campaigns of the FDC president now, that I hope some of the things they said were campaign issues. And I want to believe, because in a campaign people say many things, including what they cannot do, including what they don't believe in. And I am persuaded that many of the things that were said were campaign issues. I remember the second time Dr. Besigye went to court challenging presidential results, he was also aggrieved that the language which was used was very bad. like Museveni had told him, you are sick, you are... And the Supreme Court said, no, the moment you take out those things from a campaign, it will not be a campaign. Said, so you can allow all that to happen. So I am under the impression that many of the things that were said were campaign issues, and then we must find a way of reconciling ourselves and then continue battling for our freedoms.
You lost the constitutional amendments on the floor of parliament that lifted the presidential age limit. Are you still a viable opposition front?
Yes, we lost because we didn't have the numbers, but Museveni also had the military, which he unleashed. We are now in court challenging the outcome of that parliamentary process, which is the Constitutional Amendment Act. And the Constitutional Court has given us a 9th April, that's when the hearing will start. I hope what Parliament, the transgressions of Parliament will be dealt with by court. If they don't, even that doesn't spell doom. This country doesn't end with us, neither does it end with Museveni.
The aftermath of the lifting of the presidential age limit saw the Honorable Igeme Naveta of Jinja East sacrificed.
First of all, yes, the campaigns in Jinja were framed as a referendum on the changes that occurred in Parliament to our constitution, but also on the propriety of Mr. Museveni. And that's why Tojikwatako, Tojigemako in Jinja became part of the themes of the campaign. I have a feeling there are many areas, because they are now about to go to Rukunjiri, and I am sure the Rukunjiri Human MP cannot survive, partly because he didn't even consult. So was Nabeta. Nabeta locked himself up in a room with a few people. We now kept asking them that the man who was locking you out of the consultations, now he wants to meet everybody for a vote.
The loser, the NRM camp, challenged the victory of your candidate, Honorable Muiru, saying that you bribed and you intimidated some of the voters in Jinja East. Don't they have a point to make?
I was the chairman of the Muiru campaign team. I was in Jinja. First of all, we are just raising money by hand-to-mouth campaign, raising money to do this and then you go and do it. Mr. Museveni gave the NRM politicians, especially Kasoi Lumumba and the candidate, a lot of money. In fact, now I am told the State House teams are still in Jinja. First of all, Nabeta never used all the money that was given to him. But also the others never used the money for the purpose for which Mr. Museveni used the money. So we didn't have money to bribe people. They brought the military on the day of the final day of the campaign, which was 13th of March. They raided our campaign headquarters, arrested our agents. By the time of voting, they were in Kayunga in police cells.
Have you ever dreamt of being in the State House one day?
Yes, I want to be in power, but I want this country managed better, so that everybody enjoys, regardless of your relationship with those who are in power or relationship with those who hold guns or put on uniform. We want to live in a peaceful... There are many Ugandans who queue at embassies. Just go at the United Arab Emirates, around the fairway every morning and you see queues. I have seen them for a whole month. They want to run away from their country, not because they want to go and live outside, but because the conditions are forcing them.
Thank you very much, Honorable Ssemujju.
Welcome.